New Australian cricket captain Michael Clarke concedes he'll have to work hard to win over the Australian public. Named Ricky Ponting's successor, the man dubbed Pup, says that he's prepared to roll up his sleeves as the Aussies begin a drastic rebuild.
The Pup has become top dog. Michael Clarke becomes just the fifth Australian Test captain in 27 years, but the first who must win over a still sceptical cricketing public.
Well, I don't know the exact reasons why it's there, but it is, and I've had it probably my whole career. So I certainly don't I don't sit here and believe I can, you know, get the whole of this country to like me.
And Clarke says he'll do it his way.
For me, it's about respect. It's about earning that respect. You know, leading the team in the right way, playing cricket in the right manner, and hopefully I can, you know, earn the respect of these the doubters that are out there, I guess.
Heralding a new era, the vice-captain is Shane Watson.
It's going to be a very exciting time moving forward, but one thing I do know is we've got a fair bit of work in front of us to be able to make sure that we are able to get the results.
It's an unusual captaincy transition, with Ricky Ponting the first in 36 years to step aside and continue playing.
Bangladesh is going to be a great test for that, to see how it all unfolds. If he can continue to play as well as he, you know, has done for such a long time, I'm certain it can work.
Clarke is the first Gen Y captain, complete with sports cars, model girlfriends and tats.
Maybe my address has changed and I have a few more tattoos than I had when I was a kid, but I think the person inside is still exactly the same.
One former cricket heavyweight says runs are more important than an image makeover.
I think he'll do well as captain. I think he needs to make some serious runs and get us on side, get the public supporting him as the outstanding cricketer that he is.
Rob Waters, 10 News.